half in the bag. Fuck movies.
I'm gonna sit in my favorite chair. Oh my goodness. Oh God, help me. Looks like Jackie Gleason's still dead. Oh, I hope it's not another Michael Bay movie.
Oh my God, it smells like... Oh!
Mr. Plinkett? I'm Jay, this is Mike. We're with Lightning Fast VCR Repair.
Oh, thank God you guys are finally here. Look, my VCR needs some work done on it.
Is that your VCR? Oh my God. Wow, that's a beaut, sir. What's wrong with it? It looks fine.
Oh, well, you see, last Tuesday I was balancing my checkbook, and Oh my God! Oh, help me!
Okay.
Yeah.
We haven't had a VCR repair job in about 15 years.
I know.
We need to milk this for as long as we can.
Well, usually the elderly are pretty stupid.
Oh God, yeah.
Our current rate right now for a repair job of this nature is about $50 an hour.
Oh. You know, you two guys, you smell like the back seat of an old taxi cab. I like that in a person. It reminds me of my dear old dad. Hard-working, blue-collar guy. Kind of guy who'd come home every night, beat his wife, and f*** his kids. If you two knuckleheads need me, I'm gonna be in the kitchen.
So we got the job?
Yeah.
All right, let's do it.
Fuck yeah!
Yeah!
All right, you go get the tools.
Okay.
I'll move chairs into the middle of the room where we can just sit and do nothing.
All right.
All right.
Let's do it.
Oh, shit.
So anyway, about the f*** saw.
Oh, right, the f*** saw.
Yeah, the f*** saw, you know.
Yeah, did you know Thomas Edison was the inventor of the f*** saw?
Really? Was it called a f*** saw at that point?
No, it was called the I Love You Saw.
Oh. I guess times have changed a little bit.
Times really have changed.
Yeah. Maybe we should actually take a look at the VCR now.
Well, that wraps up this episode. We'll see you guys next time when we're going to review the new,
half in the bag. Get this crap off my desk.
Mr. Plinkett, hello?
We're here to keep working on your VCR.
Some more.
Yeah.
Longer still.
Where is he?
I don't know.
Oh, hey, look, there's a note.
Oh. What does it say?
Taking a nap, leave me the fuck alone.
Oh, that was polite of him.
Yeah.
Let us know.
Yeah.
Oh, he's taking a nap, huh? You want to rob him?
We're already robbing him.
Yeah.
I mean, physically, what are we going to do? Take his fucking curio?
Well, why don't we make use of these chairs?
Yeah, I could use a seat. I'm a little tired from when we walked in the door 2 seconds ago.
Shit, that's about as much work as I'm doing today.
Hold on, I'm coming. Hello?
Oh, are you Mr. Plinkett?
Yeah.
I'm Amy. I'm going to be doing the massage that you scheduled for this afternoon.
That's right. The doctor said I got knots all up and down my stupid back.
Okay. Well, I know you said you had a professional massage table here, but I don't see one, and if you don't have it anymore, we can do this back at the office.
I ain't going no damn office. All right. There we go. Now we're gonna get it on.
Half in the bag. Fuck movies.
Oh. Hey. You owe me $4 for this beer, you cheap fuck. How's the VCR repair work going?
Oh, pretty good. I've spent almost the entire day trying to wear down the batteries on this flashlight.
Oh.
So it's almost there, I think. How long have we been working on this VCR now?
Oh, geez. Several weeks, at least.
Yeah. It's a good thing this old bastard has no concept of time.
I think that's because he died.
Oh, really?
Yeah. He went into the bathroom, like, 3 days ago, and he hasn't come out.
I guess that would explain the pool of blood that's forming outside the door there.
And the smell of decomposing humans.
It does smell a bit like an open grave in here.
We'll give it a couple days, and if he doesn't come out of the bathroom, we'll just steal everything in his house.
Okay.
And then we can burn it down to get rid of the evidence.
That sounds good, yeah.
Half in the bag. Get out of my living room!
Nightmarish, flesh-eating army of walking corpses rules the earth.
Oh, hey.
Oh, hey, what's up?
Oh, I just got back from seeing Sucker Punch.
Oh. Yeah, you know, I actually saw that yesterday.
Yeah, they gave me this free promotional poster.
Oh, well, let me take a look at that.
Right here.
How's your eye? I didn't mean to punch you right in the face.
How do you accidentally punch somebody directly in the eyeball?
I think I was trying to punch the poster. Mm. And you just happened to be behind it.
It was just a compulsive thing?
Yeah, when okay. I saw the poster, I wanted to punch it. I don't know, it was...
Why do you suppose Mr. Plinkett would have a pregnancy workout video?
Oh, do you think Plinkett's into pregger porn?
Hmm.
Do you think that turns him on?
I don't want to think about what turns Plinkett on.
That's true.
What do you think turns Denise Austin on?
Well, probably vaginal penetration.
You guys done fixing my VCR yet?
Oh, Mr. Plinkett, we have to order some parts. That's it, yeah.
Yeah, whatever. Look, I was rooting around in my attic, right? And I finally found my old VHS recordings in Night Court. You guys can take a break from fixing my VCR. I want to watch this tape.
But it's still broken.
No, Mr. Plinkett, it doesn't work yet. Don't put the tape in.
What are you doing? Get out of my way! Damn it!
No, don't put the tape in!
Shut up! Oh dear! Oh my God! What happened? My precious light cord!
Oh, my face! God damn it! Half in the bag. These jerks can't fix the VCR right.
So, are you looking forward to seeing Your Highness?
I don't know. I heard Natalie Portman uses a body double in it.
So that's not her ass?
Apparently not.
Well, whose ass is it?
I don't know.
Is there a way to find out?
I'm assuming you can find it on the internet somewhere.
Well, I'd like to know who I've been masturbating to for the last 6 weeks.
Hey, are you two sitting there talking about masturbation on my dime?
No.
No.
Because that reminds me, I gotta hang up my new picture of Jesus. There is.
Mr. Plinkett, that's not Jesus.
Of course it's Jesus. Jesus can look like anybody because he lives in your heart. And my Jesus looks like a sexy little black girl. Well, I'm gonna hang it up now. You guys wanna help me? Help me get it straight and level now, because I want it to look good in my wall. What do you think?
Lower, a little bit lower.
Up.
Okay.
Up. Straighter.
Straighter.
Yeah, no, that's sideways.
That's the opposite of straight.
Can't you tell that the face is sideways?
Yeah. Actually, right there. That's
right there
perfect.
Is perfect.
That's great. Yeah.
Doc! Whitehead! I don't want to goddamn press that, you stupid picture and
that. Wow, that was a disaster.
Yeah.
So speaking of horrible wastes of time, have you seen Plinkett since this morning?
Yeah, I saw him in the kitchen just a minute ago. He said he was leaving and that we should leave the house for the next 6 hours.
Why would we want to do that? I mean, there's cold beer in the fridge and there's...
Oh, I'm going to kill the
what is this? What's going on?
Oh, oh my God! Oh, Jesus Christ!
Oh, jeez! Oh my God! What are you guys doing in here? This is a major cockroach hive. Didn't anyone tell you to leave?
What?
My insides hurt.
My brain hurts.
Hey! What? Have you seen Samurai Cop? Hey, sorry I sprayed you guys with those noxious chemicals.
Yeah, are those gonna give us cancer?
Yep. So Samurai Cop, you saw it, right? I've seen it 100 times.
Really?
I can't not watch it. It's very compelling.
Wow.
So how is this place is really a cockroach-infested nest?
Well, I mean, you should see it when I don't come in.
How often do you come in?
Weekly.
Oh, okay. I'll have to keep that in mind.
I'm really just holding them back. We call it pest control, you know, not pest eradication.
Yeah, okay.
But your badge says pest extermination.
Half in the bag. I don't even know who I am anymore.
God, what are you doing? Oh. You know, there's easier ways to do that.
What, a bottle opener?
Don't you think Plinkett's gonna notice that?
What, a knife in his wall? No, look at all the stuff we've done around his house. I mean, the other day we lost his kitchen, and he didn't even notice that.
Why do you even have that knife, though? I mean, who do you think you are? Courtney Cox's plastic surgeon?
Half in the bag. Fuck movies.
Hey guys, welcome to another episode of Half in the Bag. I'm your host, Jay Bauman, and as you can see, Mike Stoklasa is actually on vacation this week. So joining me is a fellow VCR repairman. He's actually a freelance VCR repairman that's helped us on a number of jobs. This is Mike Spaduski.
Hi, I'm the other Mike, and I'm glad to be here today.
Yeah, and we just saw the movie Super. Mike, what did you think of Super?
I thought it was very entertaining. I liked the movie.
Hello?
Mike, you have to come back from your vacation. When people tune into Half in the Bag, they want to see Mike Stoklasa and the other guy. They don't want to see the other guy and another other guy.
You're right. The fraud ratio has gone from 50% to 100%.
Yeah, the other Mike sucked. He was awful, so I shot him in the chest multiple times with a gun.
Oh my God. We've jumped the shark. Half in the Bag's gone downhill since episode 6. Hang on, I'll be right there.
Batman.
So, Hotshot, What's it like to kill a man?
Ugh. Have you ever been so overcome with guilt that it weighs heavy on your soul and you know it's going to eat away at you for the rest of your life? Well, it was nothing like that.
What?
Oh my! It's Milwaukee's real-life superhero, The Watchman!
I was out patrolling the neighborhood, and I just heard two very loud people talking about movies. Mind if I join you?
Here comes the Watchman. He is a real-life superhero, keeping his eye on Milwaukee.
The most important piece of equipment I carry on me is my cell phone. If I need to call, please call 911. That's what I'm going to do first.
So we're here with Milwaukee's real-life superhero, The Watchman. Thanks for stopping by, Watchman.
Well, I'm glad I could make it.
You were out patrolling the neighborhood?
I mean, that's what I do. I patrol neighborhoods.
Awesome. And you heard us talking about movies, right? Nothing else?
Nothing else.
Hey, Sam! No.
Okay.
Okay.
Okay, good.
So you are a real-life superhero.
That's the popular term for it, is real-life superhero. It was, I guess, coined by the media.
So, like, hypothetical situation. You kind of walk into a house, right? And some people are talking about movies. You know, while you're talking about movies, you happen to notice that they may or may not have murdered someone behind you, right in front of you, actually. What would you do, hypothetically?
This is
speaking,
hypothetical, of course.
They may or may not have shot someone.
Multiple times in the chest with a gun.
And you'd be trying to hide the body. Would you beat them with that flashlight, or?
I would call the police. I mean, the person's already dead, right? I'm not going to be able to save them.
No, they've been dead for what is it, an hour?
At least an hour,
okay.
Hypothetically.
If they're dead, there's nothing I can do. It would be more... call the police, report it.
What if the person that was shot was really bad at what they were doing?
They were like a really bad movie host, movie review host.
Yeah.
They deserve to die. Would you pretend not to notice the body and leave quietly, or would you beat them?
Hey, is that...
Oh, no.
That's Little Monsters with Fred Savage.
Check it out. Go ahead. Check it out. Go ahead.
That's the real crime. By the way, I've already called the police about that dead body. Bang, bang.
Half in the bag. Fuck movies.
The first thing that stands out is the nice costume. You obviously see a movie like Spider-Man or Batman, and the studio's paying a lot of attention.
Wow. Yeah, you were right.
Yeah, he was just terrible.
Normally this department frowns upon murder, but in this case, I think I'm going to make an exception and not report this.
Wow, thank you, officer.
Yeah, I mean, we thought we were screwed when the Watchman sold us out. This fucking stupid crime fighter.
Murdering an untalented, pathetic loser who wants to be yet another internet film critic is hardly a crime. At least it shouldn't be. In fact, we're glad to have citizens out there like yourselves who are willing to do their part.
Yes! More murders!
Well, should we head back to the station, Cooper?
Actually, sir, I'd like to stay and ask these boys some additional questions.
Is there something else we can help you with, officer?
You boys live here?
Actually, no. This is Mr. Plinkett's house.
Yeah, we're a VCR repairman.
Are you aware that having more than 12 beer bottles in a non-recyclable container is a violation of city ordinance?
You bet.
We love beer.
Are you wearing that new Britney Spears perfume?
Oh, yeah, Fantasy.
Yeah. How the fuck do you know what it's called?
No. Nope. Macy's. Had a big bust earlier. Man, perp. Trying to steal panties and really crappy perfume. You do what you gotta do. Tackle the guy. Got perfume all over me. It's part of the job. Love the job. Go, police!
You don't talk like any cop I've ever met before.
Yeah. What? You sound more like an undercover hooker to me. You know, if you are and we ask you, you have to tell us, because that's the law.
Shit, no! I ain't no hooker. Boo to hookers. I'm a cop.
through and through. What are you guys doing? Watching the game? Hanging out?
We're actually on a 4-hour break. We were gonna watch Troll 2.
Holy shit! I love that movie. I'm gonna go to get a beer. You guys want anything?
Sure.
Sure.
Yeah. She ain't no cop.
No.
Troll 2, man, that's great. I love it.
Hey, you guys are almost out of beer. I had an ice cream party in your kitchen. I hope you don't mind.
I didn't even know Plinkett had any ice cream.
Oh, he doesn't. I shit in my hand and smeared it all over the floor. Oh my god!
By the way, Officer, what was it?
Cooper.
Cooper. Yes. I just happened to notice you wear a lot of makeup for a cop.
I do?
Yeah. Isn't there some sort of regulation about not looking like a whore when you're on duty?
What's next?
What do you mean, what's next?
Well, you said you had like 4 hours to kill, so could we watch another movie?
Well, we could watch Best Worst Movie. It's the documentary about Troll 2.
Holy shit, let's watch that. First, I gotta take a major piss. Can I use your bathroom, or do you just want me to go in the bushes? Well, boys, it's been fun watching movies with you, but I'm afraid I need to get back to work.
Oh. Okay.
But first, I'm afraid I'm going to have to issue a citation for violating the city's open beer bottle law.
Really? Even after all the fun we've had talking about Troll 2?
The law's the law, boys.
All right.
What's going to happen is I will write you the citation. You will need to go down to City Hall to pay it. The fee will be $20.
Okay, fine, whatever.
Okay.
I've written them the ticket, and they have agreed to pay it.
What? I knew it! You're a hooker! You're an undercover hooker!
Sorry, boys. I'm just doing my job as a hooker!
You bitch! You lied! You're worse than a goblin!
All we wanted to do was just watch Troll 2 and Best Worst Movie.
Too bad! Now it's time for you to pay us money to perform humiliating sex acts!
Fine. Damn you, cop hooker! You won't get away with this!
Come on, girls. You know what to do. Fuck those losers!
Half in the bag. Get this shit off my cabinet!
What is this?
It's Sing Along with Frank Worley.
Oh my god. He has the voice of an angel. What are you doing with the Frank Worley tape?
Oh my.
That's what I'm doing to the Frank Worley tape.
Who do you think you are with that hammer? MC Scat Cat?
No. I think I'm fucking Thor, the god of thunder. By the way, have you seen Couples Retreat? It's a really funny movie.
Take a breather. Let's work those outer thighs. Up, down, relax your neck muscles. Let the legs do the work.
Yeah.
No more saddlebags. Here we go. Down, up, you got it. Lean your body weight slightly forward.
I don't even know who you are anymore.
What?
You realize we're watching a pregnancy workout video, right?
Yeah, I realize that. It's fucking hot. Hey, why'd you hit stop? You asshole. What would you rather be watching? Joe Silverman's Hollywood Dog Training Program?
Is that a book?
It's a big VHS tape.
Oh my god.
Oh.
There's cassette tapes in there too.
It's a whole program for Hollywood dog training.
Why does Plinkett have that? He doesn't even own a dog.
I don't know.
That looks unwatchable.
Speaking of unwatchable, have you seen The Hangover Part 2? Good old Richard Simmons. I love his tapes.
Oh, yeah.
He really helps out fatsoes.
Oh, absolutely. They need all the help they can get.
Yeah.
They're repugnant.
Well, it's like once you go over a certain weight, you're no longer human.
I mean, Fatso should be chained and put in a zoo for all I care.
Yeah. Well, it's good because Richard Simmons wants Fatso's to avoid that kind of shame and ridicule by making them lose weight so they don't look so repugnant.
Did you know Richard Simmons used to be a porker?
Really?
Mm-hmm. He was like 300 pounds.
Holy shit.
Yeah, because, you know, there's a lot of calories in semen. But Richard Simmons, you know, he really gives me a hard-on. You know, he helps the Fatsos, you know, lose the weight and feel good about themselves with these tapes. So. This is my favorite part of this tape.
You've seen this before?
Yeah, of course, a lot of times. But tracking's off again.
Wait, the tracking?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
On the VCR?
Yeah, there it goes.
We've been watching VHS tapes all afternoon, so the VCR works.
Yeah, obviously. What's your point?
We're here to fix the VCR. It's supposed to be broken.
Oh, fuck, that's right.
I completely forgot.
Why is it working? Oh, shit. You know what? I think I accidentally fixed it a couple weeks ago.
What?
I'm sorry. It was like second nature, you know, because I'm a VCR repairman.
I guess you did it without even thinking of it.
I was just on autopilot pretending to fix it, think it was over there, and I think I might have fixed it. Obviously, I did.
Oh. What are we going to do about this?
There's only one thing we can do.
No, not the Hollywood dog training program.
No, that's too much work. Let's just unplug it.
Half in the bag.
It's nice having a week off from the VCR repair game, wasn't it?
I haven't touched this VCR in a month.
What'd you do in your week off?
Well, I saw a couple of films at the theater. I saw The Green Lantern.
Oh.
And Mr. Popper's Penguins.
What did you think of them?
Oh, I didn't actually see them.
Oh.
I bought a ticket for The Green Lantern, but I didn't watch it.
Okay.
Because I have a fetish. It's like a sadomasochist fetish for being publicly humiliated.
Okay.
It really, it fucking turns me on. Like, so I go, one for The Green Lantern, and the girl behind the counter goes, like that, and I go, snicker at me. And then I come back after it's over, and I say, one for Mr. Popper's Penguins, and then everybody was laughing at me.
Yeah.
You know, they say, who would see this movie? And I said, I would like to, and then they just started laughing in my face. And
okay.
Little did they know I had a raging hard-on.
Well, hey, everybody. Welcome to another episode of Half in the Bag. I didn't see you there.
Oh, I didn't know we were rolling.
Yeah, we've been rolling.
Can you cut that out?
Yeah, I'll cut
the
it out.
The whole conversation.
I'll cut that whole part out.
Okay. Yep. It's, wow, it was terrifying.
It turned out to be more of a horror film than I think we originally planned.
Yeah.
I mean, that robot was just...
Yes, I wouldn't want to get raped by that robot.
Oh, dang, it must be my birthday, because I found some white boys.
Oh!
I can ejaculate at 1,000 words per minute. You're not even the best I've had.
Half in the bag. These jerks can't fix the VCR right.
Who is it?
It's Mailman Tommy.
Oh, fuck.
Every time that guy comes here, he's got some kind of fucking attitude problem. I'll get it.
All right.
Okay, you can start knocking now.
I only knocked once.
What the fuck?
What?
Hey, Mike. Jay, how's the VCR business?
Yeah, it's fine. What do you want?
Oh, got this package here from Mr. Plinkett. Can one of you guys sign for it?
Yeah, just give it to me. I'll take it to him. Yeah, thanks.
Okay, all right.
Yeah, bye. Hey, dickbag!
Yep.
You want to close the fucking door behind you or what?
Absolutely. Have a good one, guys. All right, bye, bye.
Who do you think you are?
The nerve of that guy.
I know. What is that?
I don't know, but it is heavy.
National Medical Supplies.
Yeah, it says return to sender. Mailing it back to him.
What's that doing here? I just sent that out last week.
The mailman was just here. He's returning it to you.
What? He can't return that. That's a defective medical product, and I deserve a refund.
Oh, God. Oh, God, what is it?
That's my used colostomy bag.
Oh, shit.
Half in the bag. I got problems inside of my brain.
Looks like Betty White's gonna die soon.
Good morning, Mr. Plinkett.
We got here early to start our shift.
Yeah.
You know, I'm paying you two $50 an hour to fix my VCR, not sit around and do nothing all day.
What are you talking about, Mr. Plinkett? We've made plenty of progress on the VCR. Look.
The only progress I'm seeing around here is you two yahoos drinking all my beer.
Now that is a lie. We buy our own beer.
Look, I'm going to the doctor for my weekly brain scan. Now, if you two schmucks haven't cleaned up all these beer bottles by the time I get back, I'm gonna fire the both of you. God, niblets.
Oh, shit.
That's bad news, brother.
Yeah. I don't want to get fired. Hey, have you seen Captain America?
I have.
Hey, wasn't there something we were supposed to do?
Talk about Captain America?
No.
Drink beer?
No, something Plinkett said before he left.
Hey, speaking of Plinkett, I think he's coming home right now. I hear his car.
Oh, shit. We were supposed to clean up all these beer bottles. He said he'd fire us if we didn't.
Oh, hot damn, you're right.
What are we gonna do now?
Wait, I have an idea.
Oh, we did the opposite of what we were supposed to do.
Half in the bag. I just pooped all over the floor.
What is that?
It's some movie called Death List.
Haven't heard of it. But maybe we could watch it when we fix the VCR. Anyways, so I'm at the bus stop this morning, right? And this little kid comes riding by on a skateboard, and he spits on me. And he goes, "F you, motherfucker," and he keeps riding. I was like, what did I do?
That's weird, because something similar happened to me on my way to work this morning. Kids today.
They just have no respect for their elders.
Hey, guys. Anybody want some snacks? Ah, fucking.
What the hell is that?
Well, it's a brick with a note on it.
People still do that?
Apparently so.
What does it say?
Your Captain America review is bullshitter. The movie is fucking awesome. To me, at least, all Marvel movies are awesome. Oh, there's more.
Oh, good.
You douchebags can't appreciate movies. What is appreciate?
I think they mean appreciate.
Oh!
They spelled almost every word wrong.
Wow, this person really liked Captain America. I wonder what they thought of Cowboys and Aliens. Theater I was gonna watch that.
Oh!
Oh! Now this one's for me.
Half in the bag. The devil is my hairdo.
Hey guys, welcome to another episode of Half in the Bag. I'm Jay.
And I'm Mike. And this week we saw Rise of the Planet of the Apes. What else happened at SciFanCon other than you got raped in the parking lot?
Half in the bag. I'm so sick of talking about movies.
Nurse Naughty. I don't think she's a real nurse.
Hey, hey. Sorry I'm late, but just got back from the Cleveland Comic Con. I had to get Lou Ferrigno's autograph.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, I just didn't have time when we were in Chicago, and he so rarely does conventions. So, what are you working on?
Oh, I just mounted a shelf. Remember all the cool stuff all the other vendors at Chicago Comic Con were giving us?
No, I don't.
Really? It just happens. Well, anyway, I thought it'd be cool to display it all here.
Well, you realize that this is not your house, right? And that you probably shouldn't be mounting a shelf in someone else's house?
What are you talking about?
What you're doing is unethical. And illegal. So if these people gave us this stuff, what did we give them in return? It wasn't money, was it?
Oh God, no.
Oh, thank God.
We gave them copies of our movie Feeding Frenzy. Don't you remember anything? You know, all this stuff is pretty neat. I wonder what all those vendors thought of Feeding Frenzy.
Hello and welcome to Half in the Bag. I'm Mike.
And I'm Jay.
Half in the Bag. Get out of my car and into my dreams.
Oh, fuck my life. Oh, what happened? No, that doesn't work. That doesn't work.
What? Oh, fuck. What is this? How did this get on my head?
What the fuck happened here last night?
There was a bunch of weird people that came over. We all started drinking. Things got really out of hand. And then Zach Galifianakis showed up.
And then after that, I don't remember anything that happened.
Holy fuck, that's just like that movie. Castaway.
Oh, that was a lot of work.
Yeah. I think we have to take a break from drinking.
I think you're right. And that's enough.
Yeah.
Oh, the VCR is gone. How can we continue to milk this man out of all of his money if we don't have the VCR? Oh shit, here he comes.
What are we gonna do?
We gotta, like, hide it somehow.
What? What's going on here? Well, that's the perfect place to put my beautiful picture of black baby Jesus.
Yeah, we thought so too.
Whatever, I'm off for the movies. I'm going to see Conan the Barbarian. My doctor wants to see if my new seizure medication is working. Look, my cat's in the bedroom. Leave him alone. He's working on a project.
You know, we should really look into figuring out where the VCR is, or we're going to lose our jobs.
You're right. And I find it awful funny that that's the only thing that got stolen here last night.
Yeah.
There were a lot of strange people here, too.
There may be more to this than we even realize.
We need to work at uncovering this mystery before it's too late.
Oh my God. Oh.
Mr. Plinkett, what the hell happened to you?
I made a wrong turn. Instead of seeing Conan the Barbarian, I accidentally went to Conan the Barber. Oh my God. Oh. Do you think I can get another barber to fix this? Somebody kill me. Somebody kill me, it hurts.
Half in the bag. I would buy that for $1.
We should probably get rid of that VCR.
Oh, yeah. What? Why is that there? What's that from?
Remember when I scared away George Lucas?
Well, just throw it in Plinkett's garbage.
No, he'll find it there, and then he'll wonder why there's a VCR in his garbage, and then he'll notice that his VCR is missing. We've got to get it away from this place.
Hey, have you ever seen The Lion King?
I have not seen The Lion King. So I was trying to figure out why all my socks keep cracking in half. Oh. And I realized it's because I keep jerking off into them.
So I joined a gang the other day.
What gang?
The Crips.
Oh, I'm a blood.
Oh.
Yeah. Oh, shit.
Oh. Oh, it's Mr. Plinkett.
Hey.
How's it going?
Hi, Mr. Plinkett.
What are you two doing here?
Geez.
Hey. Aww. What a cute little doggy. Yes, you are. You're a cute little puppy dog. Aw. Good,
is
good.
Is he blind
little
or stupid?
Boy.
Yes.
Get your treat from somewhere or other. Oh! Looks like your dog crapped on the sidewalk.
Well, that was unexpected.
Hey, cute dog.
Half in the bag. Fuck movies.
So, Jay, how's your sex life?
I finally got around to trying one of those fleshlights. It's not all it's cracked up to be.
Oh, thank God. Yes, come in, please.
Hey, guys, what's up?
Hey, it's Alexander Philippe, the director of People vs. George Lucas.
Yeah, so my car broke down and I was just wondering if maybe I could, like, use your phone?
Sure. It'll be $1. So what would Darth Vader do if he just suddenly had to throw up inside his space mask?
I don't know, like throw up all over his face, maybe?
Yeah, but he wouldn't have time to, if it was like a sudden
Are you still talking about Star Wars?
Of course.
Yeah, what else is there to talk about?
You know, I think I'm gonna go because I'm an adult and I have adult things to do that isn't talking about Star Wars. So okay. I'm gonna go.
All right, fine, whatever. Daily I get emails that are sometimes this long. And I'm just going to share some of those with you.
Oh, please, yeah, I'm curious.
If George wants to have his way with the special edition, at least he shouldn't do it stupidly. Mm. I hate him. I hate his face. May the Force be with you.
Yeah, right there, right? That's Star Wars fandom right there.
Fuck George Lucas. I am 30 and grew up watching Star Wars. A real fan of the idea of the Force before it became Aryan-esque and Nazi-like. Lucas can shove every one of those microscopic midi-chlorians up his wiener hole until he pisses lightning.
Wow. Wow, that's intense. That's intense.
Well, that certainly is a lot of emails. I'm done with those. Mm-hmm. Let's just go back to talking negatively about George Lucas for the next 3 hours.
Yeah, why not? You know, I'm a documentary filmmaker. It's not like I have a real job.
Oh, my God.
Well, well, well. Look what we have here. Alexander Philippe and Mike Stoklasa together in one convenient location.
Lucas, you fraud! How did you find us?
Never mind that. According to my lawyers, it's perfectly acceptable to kill you, as long as I get rid of the evidence. And what better way to do that than with a huge bomb?
Oh my God, a bomb that big will blow up the whole block.
It's time to die. When I make my biography, you two will be little more than deleted scenes. In fact, I'm about to alter you both. Not digitally, but with this bomb. It's a maneuver I like to call the special edition. I sense a presence I have not felt since... No! That's not what I think it is it?
That's right, fuckhead. It's Star Wars, the original 1977 unaltered version.
Ah! No! I fixed this all years ago! This isn't my true vision that I keep changing. No! Oh!
I bet you have.
Ah!
Oh, shit, the bomb. What are we gonna do?
Quickly, throw yourself on it.
Why do I have to jump onto the bomb?
Well, you're the least important person in this room.
Look, you can't tell someone to jump onto a bomb.
Oh, quit being such a selfish asshole. Just jump on the bomb already.
Look, I already saved the day with the TV and I made him run away. Like, I think I've done enough here. Why don't you jump
on the
bomb?
There's not much time. Quickly, before it explodes. Oh.
Oh.
Just put it out.
So, this is what you guys do with your lives?
Unfortunately, yes.
Yes.
Hmm. Well, I have to head back to LA. I have a meeting with a big name distributor in the morning.
Oh. Mm. Okay.
So, what are you guys up to now?
We were planning on watching Zat. It's a movie about a man that turns himself into a giant catfish.
Oh.
Half in the bag! When are these fucks gonna fix my VCR?
Well, that's that.
Hey, look!
Is it Jay Leno's chin?
No, no, that's too big to miss.
Oh.
It's actually the Milwaukee Film Festival.
Oh, yeah, look at that.
Let's go check out some films there, you know, ones that aren't the big, dumb Hollywood movies we've been watching lately.
That's a great idea. Let's go.
Well, that was an interesting experience.
I certainly feel a lot more enlightened now as a film fan.
Well, now you can tell people you watched a movie with subtitles.
Mm-hmm.
And you could seem like you're smarter or better than everybody.
Yeah, well, movies with subtitles, you know, that means you have to read while watching the movie, so it makes you feel more intelligent. It makes the movie seem more intelligent.
Well, if a movie's foreign, it automatically is more intelligent.
That's true.
Because foreign is, you know, it's different and it's better than everything.
It makes you better, too.
For watching.
As a film fan, I don't watch foreign films on my TV because I don't even own a TV.
Oh.
So I only see films in the theater, especially foreign films.
Right. You only watch foreign films.
Mm-hmm.
Because American films are just all garbage.
Yeah, it's like that movie Amelie. Have you heard of the movie Amelie?
I've heard of it, yes.
Oh, and then it's crap.
Oh, because I've heard of it?
Yeah.
Well, it played in major cineplexes.
I know, that's a bullshit fake foreign movie.
Oh. I forgot to tell you.
What is this?
I invented a time machine.
What?
Yeah.
Why didn't you tell me about that?
I don't know. Just never found the right time.
Oh my god.
Yeah. It works like this. You activate the time beam and then
oh Jesus Christ.
I'm so sorry. Oh gosh, actually yeah, that the time beam will give you cancer.
Oh Christ. How long does it have to be pointed at you to give you cancer?
It's actually measured in milliseconds, or was it microseconds? Anyway, I'm very sorry. You should probably go see a doctor. As soon as you can. It's most likely going to be a malignant brain tumor.
I'm pissed about the cancer.
I'm really sorry. But anyways, yeah, it's amazing.
Holy shit. Do you know what we could do with that?
Go back in time so that we could be extras in the Mel Gibson film, The Patriot?
No, no, you fucking retard. Remember that party we had a few weeks ago?
And while we're there, we could tell Heath Ledger that he's going to die. But the funny thing is, we'll tell him he dies in a different way.
I'm uncomfortable with all of this. No, no, you remember that party we had a few weeks ago?
Yes, I remember. The party we didn't remember.
Yeah. Oh. That's the night the VCR was stolen.
Yeah.
What if we went back in time to that party and took the VCR before it gets stolen?
What are you getting at?
What if we went back in time to that party and took the VCR before it gets stolen?
That, my friend, is a brilliant idea.
Oh, shit.
Oh, I'm sorry. But yeah, you're right. That's a brilliant idea. Let's go! Oh, why did you freeze?
Oh, I don't know.
I haven't hit the button yet.
I just, when I think of old TV shows, they freeze and then they disappear. But...
Well, yeah, this isn't that.
Oh.
This is a highly technological piece of equipment. It's calculating the time circuits and
how fucking
time space
long does
continuum
that take?
And at least a minute.
Jesus Christ.
What are you so anxious about?
What am I
about?
Supposed to do? Just sit here until that thing takes us back
in time?
It's
about ready. God, you're so fucking impatient with the time machine. Fucking stupid idiot. Let's go! Wow. I don't remember any of this. But who would have thought we could throw such an awesome party?
Who are all these people?
Look. There's the VCR.
Yes.
Let's get it.
All right.
Snap out of it.
Yes.
Stick to the mission.
The VCR. Okay. I'm going to get it. I got it.
All right. Nothing to see here, folks. Just leaving with the VCR.
Yep. I'll be right behind you.
Oh,
just
right.
Go ahead.
Okay.
Just go ahead.
Jay!
Oh, I'm going to come now. Did anyone bring the Heathcliff DVDs? Oh, fuck! Shit! Oh, wow, look. It worked.
Yeah, we got the VCR back.
Yeah. You know, I just thought of something.
What's that?
What if it was us that stole the VCR all along?
Oh, I think you just melted my brain.
It's called a causality loop.
What does that mean?
It means that we created the problem that we tried to fix.
That's so crazy.
Mm-hmm.
Well, I'm gonna go kill myself now.
Oh my God!
Holy cow!
Holy shit, look! It's Lady Gaga!
I love your music!
Who? No, no! I'm Plinkett's great-great-great-grandson, and I've come from the future!
But wait, Mr. Plinkett says he doesn't have any children.
He doesn't. Yet. In a few years, he gets a little bit freaky with a prostitute.
Ew.
I hate my great-great-great-grandmother. Anyway, hand me the VCR!
Why would you go back in time for a VCR?
Hey, that's what we did.
Oh, yeah.
Where I come from, those things are highly sought after by collectors. Why, I could probably get about $1 billion for that one right there. Now hand it over.
Yeah, but why do you want that VCR specifically? Number one, it's broken. And number two, you can get a VCR anywhere. Any thrift store will have like 10 of them for sale. They're just like $5.
Shut up! Stop asking me perfectly logical questions and hand over that thing.
All right, fine, here.
Oh shit, I broke my time machine. I can't get back to the future.
Well, that's a pickle, isn't it?
Well, I'm off to the whorehouse. Hey, what's going on here? Who's that guy? He looks just like me. I don't remember having a twin. After I was born, my mother said she wasn't gonna have any more because she didn't like me very much. She's... Oh!
I no longer exist!
Oh! Oh, my groin!
Half in the bag.
Apes are popping.
What are all these chairs doing here?
That's a good question.
Yeah.
Who's that guy?
Oh.
Oh, good. Our beer is here.
Yeah.
$6.50.
There you go.
I'll be back with your change.
Thank you.
Was that a waitress?
Yes.
What's going on?
Hey, how are you guys? Thanks for coming out tonight. Ready to make some laughter, Milwaukee? Yeah, it's time to laugh. I'm Rhoda Rodenstein. Let's get our Laughenstein on.
Was there always a stand-up comedian there?
So I happen to suffer from a disorder. Yep. It's called telekinesis. I just can't restrain myself from transporting from one place to the next. I think that's what telekinesis means. Or that's what my doctor says, because that's all my copay can afford. What? Insurance. Give me a high five.
No? Oh, Mr. Plinkett.
What?
Well, I wanted to ask what's going on here. What is all this?
Money was a little tight this month, so I decided to turn my porch into a comedy club. It seemed like the most logical solution.
I happened to be in the bedroom getting intimate, you know what I'm saying? Whoops, teleported right inside my jam box, my boom box.
How are we supposed to get any work done on the VCR?
Fuck you! There's a 2-drink minimum. Goddamn assholes.
Thank you, and good night!
Oh, at least that guy's leaving.
This is intolerable.
Yeah.
What's up?
Oh, hey.
Hey,
How's it going?
Taking a break before the 10. Mind if I take my break here?
Fine with me.
Sure, yeah.
So you guys come here a lot?
Actually, we're here all the time.
Oh, awesome, you're hardcore fans.
No.
Yeah, so what do?
Oh, we usually just kind of sit around and talk about movies.
Oh, I just saw a movie.
Oh.
Yeah, it was awesome. I mean, it was like probably the best movie of 2011.
Wow, what was it called?
What's your number?
Oh.
I've been killing it all night, but you guys are awesome. Thank you so much. Good night.
Oh, thank God it's over.
I'm so glad she's done with the fucking comedy. It's so bad.
You guys, right?
So, oh, that was
really
hysterical.
Great set.
Really
great
funny.
Set. Brilliant.
Thank you.
Really
funny.
Was.
Thank
really.
You.
Yeah.
So I'm done for the night. What are you guys up to?
Oh, actually, we were planning on watching a film.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, what?
It's called The Black Ninja.
Justice by day and payback by night.
Let's check it out.
Okay.
We don't have a DVD player.
Well, that certainly was the worst film about a black ninja I've ever seen.
I don't know. How do you feel about Troop Beverly Hills?
Oh, yeah, I love Eddie Murphy.
Shut up! You! Get out!
Why?
I'm closing down the comedy club. You're out of a job, sweetheart.
Well, back to the laugh bucket.
I'm sorry, but this is really good news for us because now we can get back to work on the VCR.
Mm-hmm. Not so fast. You see, the comedy club's been bought out by an IKEA.
Half in the bag. Why the fuck are you watching this?
We're back!
Somebody there?
Another day, another dollar. Time to get back to work.
Where have you been for 4 weeks? My VCR ain't gonna fix itself. Well, I still can't watch my copy of Russian Terminator. Damn it.
You're what? Wait, what?
You're supposed to be here to fix my VCR. I'm paying you $75 an hour, God Niblet.
To do what?
To fix my VCR. You've been doing it for 6 months.
Oh, shit. Yeah, we've been working on that. Jay's actually outside getting some extra parts that we ordered from the... He's getting some extra parts in the car. Couldn't do much work without those parts. Ah, good, you brought the parts.
Those are the parts? You're going to fix my VCR with beer steins?
Beer steins.
What?
He still thinks we're fixing the VCR.
Oh.
You're gonna have to talk up. I can't hear you when you whisper.
How about a toast?
Sure.
To Adam Sandler's career.
May he continue to make more films.
Cheers. That's bad luck, right?
Yes.
I hope so.
So, Jay, what does it feel like to be dead inside?
At least now I can get that job I've always wanted at the post office.
What?
Oh. Somebody's here.
Apparently.
Oh, hold on, I'm coming.
Wonder who it'll be.
I don't know. It's always someone.
Hi! Why, it's my sister, Harriet Plinkin. Hi, Harry. I'm in town for Thanksgiving. Oh, I brought all of my dogs so they could play with your cat. I'm going to be staying for 8 months. I can't wait to do all of the fun things there are to do in New Jersey. I can't wait to see the Cockroach Museum. And I can't wait to see the junkyard and the rats. How are you doing, Harry? You're a little bit balder than you were last time I saw you. Oh, and you're so fat.
They're so crazy.
Well, I'm
so
here. I said that wrong. Oh well.
Listening to these two gives me heartburn.
Well, I've been thinking I kind of want to adopt an Indian child.
Oh, that's nice.
Take them into my family. So I can start a sweatshirt.
I just love listening to your dumb ideas. I don't know why you'd be getting an Indian child.
Ah, relief.
Our incontinent mother says hello. Or at least that's what my medium tells me. She charges me $800 a minute to talk to our sweet mother. Isn't that crazy? Oh, I see you've got some people over fixing your VCR. You getting a good deal on that? The people fixing my rotary phone are taking forever. They drink all the time and they don't do anything. That's like a weird parallel between us. We have lots in common. Isn't that crazy?
You're such a stupid bitch. You always gotta come to my fucking house when you're on vacation. Can't you go to Florida or somewhere nice? It's fucking New Jersey. Who the fuck does that? Whatever. Cunt.